One. Today we are going to see the first problem of exercise 9.1. Arrange the marks of 40 students in a table using tally marks. Find how many students obtain marks equal or more than 7. So here the marks of 40 students are given in a table. We have to solve this marks using tally marks and we have to find the solution. So before going into the solution, we have to know what is meant by tally marks. Tally marks is the group of 5 lines or the set of 5 lines in which the first 4 lines we must draw vertically and the 5th line you have to draw diagonally over the previous 4 lines. So again I will repeat the tally marks definition. That is, tally marks is a group of 5 lines in which the first 4 lines you have to draw vertically and the 5th line you have to draw diagonally over the previous 4 lines. So now I am going to tabulate these marks using some headings, that is marks, tally marks and number of students. So see in this table, so here what are the digits, what are the numbers are written here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So from 1 to 8, the numbers has been written here and so many digits are repeatedly written here. So first of all, this marks I will be putting here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is here. 6 is here, 7 is here, 8 is here and 9 is here and no other digit is present there. So I just put the marks in a tabular column as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then we have to draw the tally marks. So first of all, for the mark 1, you need to count how many times it has been repeated. So see the first row, 1 has been repeated one time and next the number 1 has been, digit 1 has been repeated the second time. So anywhere else? So only 2 times the digit 1 has been repeated. So 2 times we need to draw the vertical lines. So 2 times. So the number of students is 2. Then 2, you need to count the number 2. So this is 1, then 2, 3. Anywhere else? No. Okay. The digit, that is the number 2, has been repeated 3 times. So you have to draw the tally marks. So 1, 2, 3. So 3 vertical lines you have to draw. So the number of students is 3. The next you need to count for the number 3. So this is 1 and 2 and 3. Okay. So the number 3 is also repeated for 3 times. So draw 3 vertical lines. So therefore the number of students is 3. So next we need to count for number 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So the number 7 has been repeated 7 times. So you need to draw the tally marks for the number 7, 4 for 7 times. So tally marks means you need to draw the vertical lines. You need, it's a group of 5 lines where the first 4 lines you need to draw vertically and the last 5th line you have to draw diagonally over the previous 4 lines. So 4, the number 4 has been repeated 7 times. So you have to draw 7 tally marks. 1, 2, 3, 4 and the 5th line you have to draw diagonally over the previous first 4 lines. Then so 5 we have completed, 5 lines we have drawn and 6, 7, because the number 4 has been repeated for 7 times. So we have to draw 7 tally marks. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5th line you have to draw diagonally over the previous 4 lines and 6th line and 7th line. So the number of students is 7. Similarly, you need to count for the number 5 also. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 times the number 5 has been repeated. So you have to draw the tally marks for the number 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and the 5th line you have to draw vertically, diagonally over the previous 4 lines and 6th line is there. Okay. Then the number of students is 6. So next we have to similarly count for the marks for 6, 7, 8, 9. So similarly when you are counting the number of times then a particular number has been repeatedly, that's off and you have to count down and you have to draw the tally marks and list out the number of students. So after putting this tabular column, finally what is our main question? Find how many students obtain marks equal or more than 7. That is, how many students has obtained marks equal to 7 or more than 7? So see in the marks, how many students obtain equal to 7 or more than 7? So you have to count it. the marks, the students obtain marks equal to 7 or more than 7. So that is 7, 8, 9. So these three values must be counted off. So how many students we have asked? So how many students, the number of students is 5, which is equal to 7. And the number of students which obtained marks equal or more than 7 is 5 plus 4 plus 3. That is 12 students. So you need to see the tabular column, that is marks equal to 7 or more than 7. So the last three data we have to count it off, that is 7, 8, 9. So corresponding to that, the number of students is 5, 4, 3. So add this 5, 4, 3. So 5 plus 4 plus 3, that is 12 students. So therefore, 12 students has obtained marks equal to or more than 7. So this is a very simple question where you need to understand the concept of tally marks. The tally marks has been drawn by the first set of 5 lines, where the first 4 lines has been drawn vertically and fifth line you have to draw diagonally across the previous 4 lines. And remaining over, you have to tabulate and put the number of students. And here the main question is how many students obtain marks equal to or more than 7. So in the mark column, you have to see how many students are getting equal to 7 or more than 7. So it is obviously that is the last three data entries, that is 7, 8, 9. This is obviously equal to 7 and more than 7. So corresponding to this marks, the number of students are 5, 4 and 3. So add it, the total number of students obtained marks equal to or more than 7 is 5 plus 4 plus 3, that is 12 students. Hope you have understood this. Thank you.